Y'all, it's Katie. Welcome back to From My Vanity, and welcome to my monthly BoxyCharm reviews and unboxings. I just got my box in the mail this afternoon, and it just happened to work out that I was going to be able to film today, so that is what we are doing. Per usual, if you didn't know, I got the inspiration to do my BoxyCharm unboxing in this style with a review at the beginning from last month's box through Jen Loves Reviews. I always have her channel linked down below, but I do want to shout her out on my videos because she was the original person who did this form of video, and that's where I got my inspiration from. So with all that said, let's just jump right into it. All right, so going in no particular order, let's talk about Wander Beauty's Baggage Claim Gold Eye Masks. I have one left over because I was gonna use it. I wanna save it for an Instagram tutorial video and I just haven't been able to film one recently, but I did try the other two and I think they're really nice. Now with that said, like, eye masks are hard because it's not something you can really tell right away, but I will say after I used this, I felt like the serum soaked right into my skin. My skin looked a little bit more hydrated. My makeup went on a little bit more easily, like my concealer looked nicer. And you know, the days I used this, I noticed that the creasing, like there wasn't any kind of creasing. There wasn't any issues with my under eyes at all. And I thought they looked really nice. So I think these are really awesome. And I do highly recommend them if you are someone who like goes to special events or just wants to have like a pamper time or like for a date night or something special. This would be nice to have. It is rather pricey for a one-time use thing that you then throw away, but that's one reason I love BoxyCharm is to get to try these things that I wouldn't necessarily spend the money on myself. I did enjoy them and I would not be mad if I got more of these or if someone gifted to them, like for a gift. These would make a really nice gift because it's just something I wouldn't spend my money on, but I enjoyed them. Next up, let's talk about the lashes I have on. I got the House of Lashes, and the style I got was Temptress. And I already knew this, but I've tested them anyway. I really like House of Lashes lashes. The band on these was very thin. It was very easy to apply. It stuck down very nicely. Now, I still have issues. I feel like I always have issues at the end of a long day of wearing it. And typically when I wear it, when I put on lashes, I'll put it on around nap time when my kids go to bed, and then I'll wear it till bed. So anywhere from 6 to 8 hours is how long I wear my lashes. And I noticed at the very end of the night, I would say the last maybe 2-3 hours, I felt the inside tips pop up. But because these bands are so pliable and very easy to bend, they just sit very nicely on my eyes. They don't pop up and stick up and look weird. I just felt them not sticking down. And I would look in the mirror to check, and looking at myself in the mirror, I couldn't really tell anything was off. Like, you don't see them just sticking straight, which I was very thankful for. But when I got up close in a mirror to remove them, I could see that the inside corner had popped off. So just something to keep in mind. I am very impressed. Overall, I highly recommend these. I think the quality is great. I've worn these like three, this is the third time I've worn them this past week for videos and just testing them out. But overall, this gets a big thumbs up from me, and I do highly recommend the House of Lashes lashes and their lash glue. It's the only lash glue that I've tried that doesn't make my eyes water and that holds on really, really well throughout the day. So highly recommend. All right, so let's go ahead and address the elephant in the room, the Laura Lee Los Angeles Party Animal Palette. This past month, you guys know, if you're watching this video, I feel like you already know the whole drama with Laura Lee. And if not, you can go check out Here for the Tea. She did a whole video on it if you want the scoop and just to get all the facts and the info. But I am still gonna review this because I kind of struggle because a lot of people are not reviewing or just not even mentioning it. The reason I am still reviewing this is because, one, if you aren't into the makeup drama in the beauty community, then you might not know or care. But two, if you got this in your palette and you're not someone who's an influencer, so you're not having to worry about using it and influencing it, you know, and sharing it on your channel, but you're just a normal makeup consumer and you got this from BoxyCharm, like, you might still want to be able to know if it's good or, you know, if I recommend it, if the quality's no good. So all that to say, I am still going to review it, but just know, no, I don't agree with Laura Lee. So anyway, let's just talk about the product. We're just gonna talk about the makeup. My overall opinion is I like half of this palette and kind of sort of hate the other half. Not hate the other half, but I really, really don't like this pink and this dark blue. The dark blue doesn't like, it's patchy. Now in saying that, I highly recommend you go check out Amy Loves Makeup. Angelica Nyquist is a great one to watch and follow for bright eyeshadow, and she made a really good point in a recent video that people who are exclusively like neutral lovers and then they review a bright eyeshadow palette might not be the best ones to get your opinion on because they don't deal with bright eyeshadows often. So in saying that, I feel like maybe this blue is just standard blue. I don't have much experience with bright blues, but I found it very patchy and hard to blend fund out and it didn't want to build up in a certain area. And when I would start to build it up, it would just kind of just get very sheer. Anyway, I feel like I'm all over the place, but I'm going to leave Amy Love's reviews. She did a video, I'm pretty sure, trying this on. She's a girl who wears a lot of colorful makeup, a lot of blues. She works with blue eyeshadows and stuff like that. So I feel like her opinion and her thoughts on this palette will be more helpful for you than my own. But overall, I thought this was a nice palette. I could definitely see myself reaching for it when I wanted to use this orange or this really unique shade here to my collection that's like a neon green. I liked both of those a lot. I am not wearing it today. I'm sorry. I usually try to wear them in my videos, but my favorite by far was the one when I used the purple on the outside and then this green on the inside of the lid, and I thought it was really, really pretty. The green is definitely something that it works best if you pack on or just build it up because it is such a sheer color. It takes a little bit of, you know, if you're wanting to use it in the crease, you're going to have to do several layers to really build it up, but it does show up, and when you use it on the lid, it does look nice. The blues I just felt like were a little too finicky, a little too difficult for me to work with, for me to want to use them again, but they are workable. My issue with the pink one, which is bottoms up, oh yeah, I meant to tell you that before. I don't like any of the names in this palette. Moving on. Anyway, bottoms up is a pink, but with glitter. And it's an extremely difficult shadow to work with. Like the purple here is like a shimmer shadow, but it doesn't have the glitter chunks that this one does. Anyway, the day I used this, I kind of was wanting to use it on my lid and I was packing it on and I happened to get, my eye was tearing up a little bit. It happened to get a little wet and it almost turned to a metallic finish. So I was like, oh shoot, the matte with a little bit of sparkle look is gone because it's not going to work anymore. Let me just spray my brush and then I will, you know, make the whole look metallic because I thought it was still pretty, the one spot that got wet. So anyway, I sprayed my brush like I typically would with Max Fix Plus, tried to apply it and it went on so patchy. Like some areas foiled up and looked really metallic and pretty and other areas just look terrible, watery, wet. I was so disappointed. I ended up having to put glitter over it because it pretty much totally ruined the look. So all in all, I did not like working with this. These two were hard to work with. These three were my favorite. So there is my review on that. Overall, this is just so-so. If you got it, you can use it. I think you can get some really pretty eye looks with it, but I'm definitely not telling you to run out and buy it. So you're not missing anything if you don't have it. All right, next let's talk about the eyeliner that I have. This is from Bang Beauty, which I've never heard of before, and it is the gel liner in chocolate. The first time I tried to use this, I tried to use that as a base because it's just not my preference when it comes to liner, and that wasn't a good idea at all because it was very chunky, so when I was trying to kind of smooth it over my lid, some areas would be a lot thicker than others, and it just didn't work out. When I tried to put eyeshadow down on top of it, I tried to put a matte down. That really didn't work out. It kind of played with the color tones in that color. It was a hot mess. I don't recommend using it as an eyeshadow base unless you really mean to sheer it out. I was using it to try to like do a half cut crease kind of thing. I did use it on today's look. It's not my favorite because I still feel like this look would just have looked a lot better with a black, but I needed to test it out. And of course it comes in the month where I have nothing but bright and fun eyeshadow palettes in my shop, my stash, my daily makeup drawer. But anyway, it's an okay gel eyeliner. It's a little bit chunky, which some gel liners can be, but my issue is when I am putting it on, it's very streaky. Like wherever you have the most pressure, it kind of looks very sheer, and then around it is a little more built up, and I kept having to go over different areas to fill it in. And then with my shimmer on my lid, right now I topped it with some glitter, but before I had just a shimmer shadow on my lid, it wouldn't go over, like it wouldn't cover that. You could still see the shimmer and the color of the shadow through it very easily. I had to do like three layers to really get it somewhat covered. So it's just a decent eyeliner. I can see if you were very fair that this would make a really pretty liner to line your eyes on very natural days. But for me, I don't see how much use I'm gonna get out of this. I don't enjoy using it. So overall, I wasn't impressed with this. You can get use out of it if you got it in your box, but this definitely isn't a product I would say go out of your way to purchase. All right, then last up in my box, I got the Smashbox Be Legendary lipstick. The reason I'm holding up two is because I received the shade Spectacle in my box. But once again, I got such a bright shade when I had nothing but bright eyeshadows to use this month. And, you know, to go with that, like, I just feel like this clashed so badly with this palette. But wanting to test out the formula and just be able to bring a refreshed review to you guys, I have been trying other of their Be Legendary lipsticks that I own. And the one I'm wearing today is 5 to 9. And I really like this formula. I already told you guys when I unboxed it that I liked it, but just wearing it this past week and kind of refreshing myself with the formula it is really, really nice. Something I wanted to share that I think is so impressive is I put this lipstick on around 10 and I had to go do errands with my children. And so we went out and did errands. Twice I remember my son kind of bumping my face, and I saw on his arm like transfer from this lipstick, and so I had a little freak out moment thinking I had lipstick all over my face, and I pulled out my phone to check, and neither time there wasn't any smudging around me, which I thought was really impressive. I don't know how it did that, because it's just a regular lipstick. It's not like it's a matte liquid lipstick. And then add to that, when I got home, I ate pizza, 2 slices of pizza, didn't cut it up, I just ate it as you normally would hold a pizza and eat it. And this is what my lips look like after that. I think that's impressive. Yes, it's worn away, sure, it's still there. And if a lipstick does that, especially a regular lipstick, still looks like that good after I finish eating, I am super impressed. I am super pleased. That's all I could ask for in a lipstick, because I feel like if I went and wore this out to eat, I wouldn't have to worry about my lipstick looking crazy if I was having a conversation with someone. I could just leave it, eat, and then whenever I happened to go to the bathroom, I could reapply or just touch up or whatever. But I would feel very confident in not looking like, you know, lipstick all over my face, or like all of it gone in the center and only like, you know, the outline lips, nothing like that. It looks really nice. It honestly just reminded me of like a stain, like my lips look stained with the color. So all that to say, yes, I still love these. I still recommend them. I am very impressed with these. I just mentioned them in my underrated, overrated makeup tag as being a very underrated lipstick line. I really like mine. All right, my favorite time of this video is to unbox the new box. I've seen a couple spoilers, but don't really know what I'm getting, but here, I'll give you guys a little peek. That's what's in my box. Let's break it down. First off, we got some coupon codes. I will put them down below and on the screen, but Laura Geller has a 30% off coupon. That's pretty good. The code is Boxy, and it expires October 15th. And then Dr. Brandt is a VIP offer. Visit us at Sephora.com and search Say I Love You to access a special limited edition microdermabrasion bundle offer just for you. Hurry, while supplies last. So I'll put the hashtag here if you guys want to go look that up on Sephora.com, but it's not a coupon code, it's just a special offer. Oh, that's really pretty. I like the colors in that. The theme is Wildflower, and then there are all the products. Let's see. First one I feel like is the most obvious, and it is the Baked Blush from Laura Geller in Tropic Hues. I actually have not tried one of her blushes, but I feel like Emily Noel talks a lot about her, maybe not her blushes, but just her baked products in general. I feel like she has really good things to say. And this is really pretty. There is a sheen to it, but it doesn't look like glitter, so that's super encouraging. Ooh, the color is really pretty. Let's see. You see that? Once again, I always put on like the bony part of my hand, which I feel like is a horrible place to swatch, but it's very reflective and just gives a very, very pretty glow. It almost reminds me of like the Milani Luminoso. It's baked blush, Katie, of course. Anyway, it's very much like that, but I'm excited to have it. I'll stick with close-ups as I always do so you guys can really see the swatch. Now, this is not something I would usually want to have or think to buy for myself, but once again, that's kind of the reason I love subscription boxes. It gets me out of my comfort zone or out of my ruts that I like to be in. So that is that. I cannot wait to try it. Okay, next up I have a Butter London Stroke of Wow Roll-On Precision. Oh, this is that pizza cut roller one. And this is from Butter London. I think I remember them coming out with it, but I just totally forgot about it. That is too weird. It, like, it feels like a pizza roller. It rolls just the same. It's kind of scared, but honestly kind of excited to try this. I've been wanting to try it, but it just wasn't something I was going to buy for myself just to try one of those fads, because I feel like that's what it was, a big fad all of a sudden. But we're going to give this a try. It is $19, so definitely something I would never have bought for myself, but I'm excited and curious to see the success that I have with this. Next, we have Alamar Cosmetics brushes. I'm so excited. I saw the green handles and like the sneak peeks, but I didn't click to look and see what brand it was. I like the color, and I'm super excited to try some more from her. They have a really nice, there's no name to them that I can see on the brush, but a really nice blending brush, a really nice flat brush that I like to use for either cutting my crease or packing the shadow onto a cut crease. And then this looks kind of like just a flat, maybe for brows, you could stamp and smoke out the lower lash line, I would imagine. But I'm really excited about these two brushes. This brush is just something I don't really have a need for. We're gonna give it a try, and I will report back to you at the end of next, or the beginning of next month, whatever, in a month. Oh, and I'm missing the biggest thing in here is the it's pretty vulgar, the Nightingale eyeshadow palette. Okay, I've never tried anything. Oh wait, I've tried a blush from I've tried something from Pretty Vulgar. Oh yeah, and I've tried stuff from Pretty Vulgar. Never mind. The only stuff I've tried from Pretty Vulgar has been in a BoxyCharm, and I think I've tried their gel liners, and then I want to say a blush, I believe. But now we have an eyeshadow palette. Not gonna lie, I'm not super into the neutral or like the cool tone colors. And you know what? We're just gonna embrace the cool tones this next month, I think. I've been really into color recently, and if it's not super colorful, I've also really been into like greens, yellows, and oranges. So this is like polar opposite to that, but we're gonna give it a try. I feel like Liv Loves Her Makeup has talked about this palette in particular and has said that she likes it. I think she says good things about it, don't quote me on that, but I'm excited to try it. So it's an eyeshadow palette. This eyeshadow palette addict is excited. And then last in my box is Lorac Cosmetic. I'm excited that they put a Lorac in here. Pro Liquid Lipstick. Ooh, I got three shades when they first launched, but I haven't revisited or tried it in a long time. I feel like I haven't worn them. This is in Deep Burgundy, a really deep shade, but I feel like it'll go along nicely with those cool tone eyeshadow looks. And yeah, I'm excited. If I remember right, thinking back, I have a review, so I can leave that link down below and we'll kind of see if I still agree with that review at the end, you know, in a month after I review this. But I remember liking it. All right, my camera card filled up, so I just had to go and empty it. So I don't, if I'm in a different area, different lighting, that's why. But if I caught it correctly, I was just swatching this. Here's what it looks like. I'm gonna be sticking in close up so you guys can really see. But I was saying that I did a review, and if I remember correctly, I really did like them. But yeah, we're gonna be trying out this shade this next month, and I'm excited. You know, this liquid lipstick loving gal is excited, even though everyone's over the matte liquid lipsticks. I just say keep them coming. All right, so there you have it. That is everything that I got in my box and the reviews from last month's box. I hope you guys enjoyed it and that the reviews at the beginning at least were informative and helpful to you guys. And I hope you enjoyed seeing what I got in this month's box. But yeah, overall, I'm pretty excited over everything I got in this box. Nothing stands out as a big dud. There are definitely products in this box that I'm just kind of so-so about. Like, I wouldn't have gone out and purchased it myself, but I'm totally fine receiving it for, you know, under $21 with other products included. I did forget, once again, I keep forgetting to mention at the beginning of the video that I do receive this box as PR. I used to pay for it, but then they added me to their PR list, which, by the way, I still have two boxes I need to do a giveaway for. I've been so bad, I meant to do them over on Instagram. And since I didn't, you know what, we're just gonna do a giveaway in here. I'm gonna do one box in here, so put up a picture. This is the box I'm gonna be giving away in this video. If you want to enter, go down below in the description box. I will have the Rafflecopter form along with all the information, fine print, details, what have you. It'll be in the description box. And then if you follow me on Instagram, give me a couple days, like 2-3 days, and I will post up the other box to enter to win over there. So yeah, enter down below if you want to win the one of the boxes, and then stick around, keep an eye out on my Instagram, and I'll have the other box going out sometime this week so I can get those giveaways out to the new winners, the new owners. But yeah, with all that said, I think that about wraps up this video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I hope to see you in my next video. Bye guys.